everyone. I, Shilpa Bhandari, faculty of MBA department from Technia Institute of Advanced Studies. Today, I'm going to deliver a lecture on the topic Compensation for the CEO, that is the Guidelines of Companies Act relating to CEO compensations. So let's understand. So as you can see, here are a few guidelines for checking a company's compensation program. Let's understand. So first one is the risk and reward. You know, the company's boards, at least in principle, try to use compensation contracts to align executives' actions with the company's success. So the idea is that CEO performance provides value to the organization. Pay for performance is the mantra most companies use when they try to explain their compensation plans. Next, that is based on the cash or the base salaries. So, you know, these days, CEOs often receive base salaries well over $1 million. So, in other words, if I talk about, the CEO gets a terrific reward when the company does well. But they still receive the reward when the company does badly. So on their own, big base salaries often little incentives for executives to work harder and make smart decisions. Next, that is the bonuses. You know, the bonuses that vary with the performance are another matter. CEOs who know they are or they will be rewarded for the performance to tend to perform at a higher level because they have an incentive to work hard. That is the bonuses which actually attracts them. Next is the stock options. You know, companies trumpet stock options as one way to link executives' financial interests with the shareholders' interests. But also these options can also have flaws as compensation. In fact, with the options, risk can get badly skewed. When shares go up in the value, executives can make a fortune from options. But when they fall, investors lose out while executives are no worse off. Indeed, some companies let executives swap old option shares for new, lower priced shares when the company shares fall in value. Next is the stock ownership. Academic studies say that common stock ownership is the most important performance driver. CEOs can truly have their interest tied with their shareholders when they own shares, not the options. Ideally, that involves giving executive bonuses on the conditions they use the money to buy shares. So at the end, and the conclusion is that assessing CEO compensation is an art. Interpreting the numbers isn't terribly straightforward. Yet, investors should get a sense of how compensation programs can create incentives or disincentives for top managers to work in the interest of shareholders. So here we are done with the guidelines relating to the CEO compensation. I hope you people understood about it. Thank you so much.